No cigars. I don't know what else to say.
What was the ups and downs today?
I didn't really feel nervous in the first, holes, but obviously I didn't quite hit the shots I was looking for. I don't know. I hung in there kind of after getting off to a terrible start and kind of got it back. And, Kenny was just playing so well, it was very hard to really compete with him. I mean, he did. He never made a mistake. And every time he got a putt inside of 12, 15 feet, he made it. And, he played great golf today, and it was hard to catch up. So I tried to put some pressure on and hang in there. And until that 13th hole, it was, I wasn't really having a chance the way he was playing, but. At least I was kind of hanging in there.
Mike, when you say par on 9, do you think it might jumpstart you a little bit? That was
without question, because that was, just kind of a miracle par. We made a bad decision there as far as taking a shot that was kind of green high. We misjudged the wind a little bit, and just obviously in hindsight, we're always perfect. So, I know I should have been playing off the middle of the green, and that's kind of what I was talking about. When we're in trouble, we got to get the ball in the middle of the green and go from there. So it was lucky to get away with one, because that was obviously a good shot but a very bad decision.
In a way, a lot of stuff really turned on the third and fourth holes there. That's that two hole stretch, didn't it?
Yeah, because he made that putt down that hill, and all of a sudden that wind blew behind me and my ball just took off down the hill on the other side, and I three putt, he one putts, and all of a sudden he's leading the tournament, and he pitches out and gets it close. And
You were trying for the green on your second shot on 4, and you hit the tree. Was that what happened?
Yeah, I was. I didn't quite catch it clean, but I had to get it up in the air, which isn't always my strength,
What was the origin club on that shot, Michael?
I think it was about 144 front, and it was, and I was hitting an 8-iron, so it shouldn't have been a big problem, but I just didn't quite get the ball clean, and so it didn't kind of get up as much as I would have liked.
After 13 and things started to look a little inevitable, what did you and Kenny start talking about out there?
Really kind of his car. He's got a new dragster he's going to get next week, and so that was kind of it. At that point, I certainly wasn't the competition anymore, and that was the hardest thing to overcome, is when you have discipline, you're trying to hang in there and keep applying a little bit of pressure, and there wasn't much, the way he was going. So that 13th hole was very depressing.
Michael, when Kenny gets it going like he has been having it going, who does he? Does he remind you of any other top player in the world?
Well, maybe someone like Johnny Miller, because he hits it pretty close, but he gets his putter going like that, and he's as good as anybody I've ever seen in the world. Maybe a Lauren Roberts. I mean, he really, he rolls the ball great. He's very long too, so he has completely different lines than I see and do. But when he gets going, he's obviously a great player.
Does it lessen your disappointment that Kenny played so well the last two rounds? He basically won the tournament.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what I joked about him going on 18. What does the first two rounds matter, last week he didn't do very well in the first round or two in Pittsburgh, and we were playing together, and it wasn't until about the middle of that second round he started going, and, he shoots 19 under in 2.5 rounds, but that's how good he can putt. When he putts great, he's one of the best putters in the world. Good.